but of all the places I visited, if you think you've really had it and you want the fuck out, the place you're going to want to go, no ifs, ands, or buts, seriously, is Tahiti. Mm-hmm. I've been there. I'm here to tell you. And even if it's just for a vacation, if you want to take a vacation that is truly one that will serve you in good stead for like a year, as opposed to when you go to the Dells and within 2 weeks of coming home, fuck, why did I go to the Dells? You go to Tahiti, Tahiti comes home with you. I am not fucking with you. And an important thing that you should note, and this I absolutely believe, is when you take a vacation, you take minimum 10 days. 7 days is bullshit. 7 days is not a vacation. And that's just a fucking fact. It's absolutely a fact. And that's how come we're so fucked up as a country. Everybody's taking 5 days, 7 days. Doesn't work that way. Because 3 days of the 7 days, oh, you're not even on vacation. Your mind's back in the office going, I can't believe what those shits are probably up to. God damn it. I hate that place. It's like being in a prison, for fuck's sake. And I left them all those fucking reports I wrote, and they won't even know what to do with it. They probably think it's toilet paper. They're wiping themselves with it. Where did they find these people? Did HR just go to a zoo, buy some, you know, chimpanzees and shave them? Is that why they fuckers look so old? And that boss, talk about a piece of shit. Who did he blow to get in charge? Son of a bitch. I can blow as well as he can. And I don't even like blowing, but God damn it, nobody offered me to go, hey, I would have done it. I maxed out 3 credit cards to take this fucking trip. And I know that I had to do that, because otherwise on Monday I'd buy an assault weapon, and on Tuesday I'd be back in that office and those monkeys be hopping. And then 3 days pass, and 100 margaritas later you're going, fuck, I'm on vacation. And why Tahiti? Because it's fucking paradise. I'm not jerking any of your chains. I am telling you the fucking truth. I know it's shocking. How could there possibly be paradise on Earth? I certainly didn't believe it. Because I've traveled all over. And generally, everywhere I've gone, as nice as it could be, there's always something that irritates the shit out of me. And sadly, that's what makes me happy. I didn't even choose to go there. I went there as a part of a group that was entertaining on a boat there. And I thought, well, fuck, I should go see it. Everybody says, you know, you really should go to Tahiti. And I didn't believe it would be paradise. I was told Hawaii was going to be paradise. Okay? When you compare Hawaii to Tahiti, Hawaii is a shithole. And Tahiti is only 2 hours further than Hawaii. So if you're going to Hawaii, stay on the fucking plane. Just go there on a vacation. Because it will change your life, and I mean it. I'm telling you, I've been all through Wisconsin, and I realize that time and again, wherever I am in Wisconsin, people stop me and go, you know that Milwaukee is the Tahiti of Wisconsin. It takes an awful lot for my brain to fucking come to a screeching halt. An awful lot. It's constantly going. It's constantly distracted by shit. It's constantly involved with, fuck, what was that, and what the shit, and God damn it. 4 hours later, after arriving in Tahiti. I'm standing on an absolutely pristine, magnificent beach, looking at water that is seven shades of blue that I realized during the week as I wandered around in the water that anywhere you went in the water, it was a sushi fuck farm. I'm looking at an island. I'm standing on one magnificent tropical island looking at another magnificent tropical island that's just totally, there's nothing, no signage, okay? No Golden Corral 6 miles. Yum, 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 looking for a coronary. And I stood there under that sun and that brilliant blue sky. And 4 hours after arrival, I was finding it difficult to form a thought. 8 hours after my arrival, I was finding it difficult to remember my parents' names. It's Sam and Mom! That's fucking close enough. Tahiti in English means I don't give two shits about anything. One of the reasons we take vacations is to be able to extract ourselves, to detach ourselves from whatever the environment that drives us fucking crazy if we're in it for too long. And it allows us to get away. And when we come back, it becomes easier to deal with the shaved chimpanzee. It becomes simpler. People pay a lot more money than it's going to cost to go to Tahiti, to achieve that kind of thing, that kind of detachment. They go to fucking Zen retreats and yoga fuck farms, and they go to they do colonics for 10 days. Maybe I'll shit it all out of me. In Tahiti, it's almost instantaneous. And the people that surround you, the Polynesian people, are absolute proof of that. I don't give a fuck. You would think in an economy that is entirely 90% it's tourist driven. That's where the money comes from. One would think that the Polynesian people, the people that I think are maybe the most beautiful people on earth, one would think that they might want to learn something besides the French in their native language. They might want to learn some phrases in English just to help the tourists. And they haven't. They know yes and no. And you can say something to them, and what you want to hear is no. And they'll go yes. And then you make a face like, and then they go no. To give you a sense of really what it's like to be there, I found myself on a beach at an outdoor cafe. The service person came over. I said, you know, I'd like a Coke. And then they went away. And 5 minutes passed. In this country, if you've ordered a Coke and you don't get it in 5 minutes, you're like, where's my fucking Coke already? There, I was thinking, oh, I wonder how I got here. It sure is beautiful. And then 10 minutes passed. And then 15. And then they came back with a ginger ale. And I took it and said, good idea.